Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover how to do in-context modeling using layout sketches. So layout sketches allow us to define multiple components from one centralized layout sketch. Now the layout sketch lives in the assembly itself, and as you can see right over here, I already have a layout sketch created. So if you did not have turned on your toolbar for the layout, which is here, so what you can do is you can just right click any of the tab, and then you can go into the tabs, and then you can just mark the layout, and then it's gonna come here automatically. And right now, as you can see, I don't have anything here. I don't have any part, so I have only layout. So I'm gonna go into the layout, and you can see I already have a sketch for the layout, and I have different lines to define my sketch, as you can see. And as you can see, the icon is changed because we are in the layout right now. So I'm gonna go back from the layout. So I would just click this, and then I'm back into the assembly. So right now I have only layout in my assembly. So as you can see, and if I'm gonna click on that, so I'm gonna go back into the layout here. So as we already just came back from the layout, so there is no part here. So the next thing is, what I would like to do is I would like to start bringing other components into the assembly. So right, let's go into the part window. So I'm gonna go, so this is my part, although it is a empty part. So what I want to do is I just want to bring this part, and I want to bring it to the assembly. So let's go into the windows, and let's tile horizontally, and then I just want to hold this component, and then I want to bring it to the assembly like this, and then I can just expand it. Okay, so this was my first part here. So as you can see, whenever we are bringing our first part into assembly, so it's automatically it's gonna be fixed. So that's why we can see a tiny F in front of the name of the part. But if I want to float it, so what I can do is I can just right click on it, and then I can float it. So now it's not fixed. So I'm gonna go into this part, and then as you know, like this part have origin, so this is the origin. So what I want to do is I just want to align the origin of this part with the origin of this assembly. So what I would like to do is I would just like to highlight the origin, and then hold the control key on my keyboard, and then select the origin of the assembly, and then I can go into the assembly, and I can create a mate. So I can create a mate, and then I can align axis for that. And this is already checked. So I'm just gonna click the green check mark, and then green check mark again. So as I created a mate between the origins of assembly and origin of my empty part. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you can find my course link, in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you. So now as everything is defined, so the next thing what I would like to do is I would like to sketch on this part. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna right click on this part, and then I can go into the fourth option, which is edit part. So as you can see, when I'm into the edit part, so all the options are turned into the blue. So what the next thing is, I would like to select a plane which is parallel to the layout sketch plane. So let's check, this is the top plane, and this is the front plane, which is exactly parallel to the sketch plane. So what I would like to do is I would like to sketch on this plane, because I want to bring the whole sketch onto this plane. So I'm just gonna right click on the front plane and sketch. And as right now I am already in sketch, so what I would like to, I would like to bring the whole sketch here. So there is an option for the into the ribbon section, which is convert entities. So this is the easiest way to bring the whole sketch onto this plane. So I'm going to click the convert entities, and then what I need to do is I need to select all the lines or sketch what I want to bring. So I'm just going to select first line, hold the control key, second line and third line, and then I can just click the right green check mark. So in this way, as you can see, I just bring the whole sketch here into my plane, which is the part plane. Okay, and the next I would like to go into the features, and then into the features I would like to extrude boss or base. So I'm just gonna click extrude boss or base, and then the first thing is how high I want to go. So let's say I want to go 10 inches, and then because it was a line, so automatically the thin feature is already selected. So 0.1 inch is a bit thin, so let's select 0.25 inches. Okay, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Okay, as I already featured the whole sketch which was referenced onto the layout sketch, so I already created this. So what I would like to do, I would like to go back into the assembly. So this is my extrude boss or base which is referenced onto the featured layout. So the next thing is what I would like to do is I would like to go into the linear components pattern, and then I would like to create a circular pattern for this part. So the first thing is like how many copies I want to have and which component I want to select. So I'm gonna go and select the whole component because I want to have a circular pattern of this component. I need to select the direction, or I just need to select a reference of rotation, so I can select this axis. Equal spacing. So I already select equal spacing and four parts, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. So in this way I can just create a circular pattern for this. So now the last and most important thing is like, because this whole component or this whole featured boss or base are based on the reference of layout sketch. So now if I want to modify it, if I want to edit the layout sketch, so this shape should be changed. So let's go into the layout sketch here and then go into the layout. And as you can see right now, the outer diameter is 24. So what I want to do is if I want to change it to 50 and click the green check mark, and then let's click the green check mark again. And let's go back out of the layout sketch. So look, you can see the whole component and the whole sketch is modified. So this was all about in context modeling in layout sketches, and you can see this is a really powerful, so you can tie one or multiple sketches to the layout sketch, and then you can just modify your layout sketch and it's gonna adjust all of your sketches which are referenced to the layout sketch. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.